early this year.
It's conducted through the week. Firstly, we go back to Olympic Park and let's have a look there at the first leg of the double.
Racing Son of Gun box well on the inside, going quickly, Brett's Bounty to join it. Brett's Bounty, Son of Gun by two lengths to Wantonville, driving over to the inside to be third, and switching out Deep Sandy's caddy, Ryder's Son, the first turn. Down the back and Son of Gun by two lengths to Brett's Bounty, Wantonville third, and railing well three or four lengths, Amber's Song. After three lengths with Caro Ritter, good break to Sandy's caddy, Ryder's Son and Katie's daughter near the turn, Son of Gun the leader. Wantonville will be the danger, getting up on the inside, but Son of Gun clear. Wantonville getting up on the inside, they hit the line, and Wantonville got up to win. It's Wantonville first, Son of Gun second, and a photo for third, Amber Song of Brett's Bounty.
Racing. Here's the second leg.
Well on the inside, going quickly as Diamond Courier. Then Cavan Flyer racing up, and then Heather's Hope, who's third. Out of the straight, Cavan Flyer took the lead fast. Eddie went very wide on the first turn and dropped out to third last. Down the back, it's Cavan Flyer by four lengths to Diamond Courier. Brandon Parker's third. They were followed by Heather's Hope on the outside, two lengths away to Automatism. Right out of it, Mystic Champion, Fast Eddie. And then came Slave Boy near the turn. Diamond Courier got up to take the lead. Heather's Hope took the split. Heather's Hope hit the lead. Here comes Mystic Champion flying it, got up. I reckon Mystic Champion on the post has nailed Heather's Hope to score.
Well, there's the double, $5. Quite an interesting race, the second leg. Let's go to Sandown. We'll have a look at the second leg of the double now at Sandown Park.
Racing. Favourite Nathan's Girl on the outside was second last, settling down. Val's a Flyer began smartly with Malika three deep, stage in into the first turn. All checked out of it there was the favourite Nathan's Girl, dropped out to last. Ahead of it, Soft Emerald around the top turn, and Val's a Flyer racing out very wide down the straight, led by three lengths to Malika. Three or four lengths stage in, Nathan's Girl over on the inside, and tracking wide at the rear is Soft Emerald. Down the back, Val's a Flyer by a half length or so to Malika, and three or four lengths away, Nathan's Girl running on strongly now. Up on the inside, about six lengths to stage in. And last of all, Soft Emerald coming off the back. Val's a Flyer, the leader. But Nathan's Girl getting up on the inside. Six lengths, Malika stage in. Nathan's Girl got up on the inside. It's been a big run, and the favourite drawing away. Nathan's Girl by four lengths to Val's a Flyer, 10 lengths away. Malika ran third, though.
Well, decent sort of a run that, wasn't it? In all sorts of trouble, Nathan's Girl. It's still won. The double down there at Sandown for 5 and 8. Paid $4.45. Now let's go to Geelong Friday night and have a look at race two.
Ready in the racing, and Swift Laser began brilliantly, the favourite on the inside. Swift Laser a length and a half clear of a line of four. Going up on the inside there is Terrigy's back, Archpick, and moving around them, World Outlook about four lengths further back in the field, Red Shroud. Dundalk Swing are tailing out with Archpick now as they run off the back. Swift Laser a length or so to World Outlook, three lengths away to Terrigy's back around the turn though, and the favourite is cruising. Swift Laser up the straight, and she's racing clear, and Swift Laser a big winner by 5 lengths to Terrigy's back.
Ready second leg.
This time, slow to begin, Altai Khan on the inside, and a good race for the lead with Wise Speculator going quickly, and Buka Sunset moving around the outside rapidly. Buka Sunset raced up on the outside, took the lead, check Wise Speculator, and they're about 4 lengths out in front of Piccadilly Boy. They were followed then by Snowy's Devil, Altai Khan. Further back then, you Epsilon, Willie O'Reilly, Pops Goldie, but Buka Sunset's got the first lead of the Guineas, all parceled up, and Buka Sunset, 6 lengths to Wise Speculator, 2 lengths away, Piccadilly Boy.
Now, the Geelong double 1 and 8 paid $2.60. Now, Cranbourne raced last night, and we'll have a look at the double there. The first leg was race number two.
Circuit Judge box well on the inside, going up quickly, Flying Satan, but Circuit Judge is the leader now from Royal Bijou up on the outside. Grand Office second and third last, running to the back, and Circuit Judge two in front. Swift Dart running second, followed by Royal Bijou, Flying Satan. A length or so then Kane Topkin, 4 lengths further back, Gypsy Die, Worthy Tune and Grand Offer, but coming off the back straight, and Circuit Judge has bolted away from the opposition, 6 lengths clear. Topkin is running up on the inside, followed by Royal Bijou, but it's Circuit Judge to win by 4 lengths of the run home to Top Gun, and Royal Bijou third, followed by Flying Satan.
Ready second leg of the dub.
Ready Master out in the centre began smartly, racing up towards the lead, settling down. Ready Master will show in front out of the straight from Norbalas out wide, and they were followed by Bossman's Image getting to third. Ready Master two or three in front down the back straight. Norbalas second. 4 lengths, Bossman's Image wanting to get off the track from Meadow Star. Back on the inside, Tamerson Magic, they were followed by Vibrant Image, and Flirty looks back at the rear, but Ready Master's 8 lengths in front on the turn. Ready Master clear, Meadow Star getting the second placing, but Ready Master is won by 8 lengths. Second is Meadow Star. Tamerson Magic third, followed by Vibrant Image, Bossman's Image.
And the double there, $2.95 for 1 and 5. All the doubles pretty short, so plenty of favourites have been winning at the Greyhounds. We're going to take a break now and then have a look at harness racing from Moonee Valley last night. Weeknight.